好，25、26條咧就問翻我哋呢一個人類嘅消化系統嘅，咁啊1、2、3、4、5、6啦，做翻一個 good practice 咧，就做曬 labeling 先啦。咁題目就問我哋啦，物理性消化究竟發生喺1、3、4邊一個嘅結構嗰處咧？咁講個選項之前咧，咁啊不厭其煩啦，都要提翻啦。物理性消化係代表啲咩咧？就係將啲嘢食拆解變成細細嚿啦，而過程當中咧係冇變成一啲新嘅嘢嘅，即係一粒魚蛋咧，你點樣嚼法嘅話咧，佢都仍然一粒魚蛋，不過細粒咗。但係佢唔會變成咗嚼到變成氨基酸啊！而當中有咩嘅重要性呢？就係增加翻嗰個嘢食嘅表面面積同埋體積嘅比例啦，去從而咧俾嗰啲酶咧容易啲去做一個化學式消化嘅。好，咁跟住啦，睇翻答案咯喎 ，Mini 咧都係講三個結構啦，1、3、4 ，labeling 就有咁嘅好處啦。今次我哋唔做咗擊破啦，我哋咧先解決第三個，就係大腸。大腸其實係冇消化可言嘅，佢要發生嘅消化咧，其實已經喺小腸咧照計係發生曬噶啦，所以大腸咧係唔會有一個物理性嘅消化啦，亦都唔會有一個化學式嘅消化嘅。而大腸嘅主要功能啦，就係喺個糞便嗰處啦，去吸翻一啲剩餘嘅水分同埋礦物質嘅啫。咁所以三號咧就已經唔係答案嚟噶啦，答案已經出現咗就係 boy。咁當然有翻啲體育精神搞掂埋佢啦。咁喺我哋個胃嗰處咧，就係有一個攪動嘅動作啦。咁你幻想下啦，你嚼完啲嘢之後咧，經過咗咁長嘅食道咧，佢會俾人揸翻咗變翻做好似個波咁樣樣嘅。咁所以啦，我哋個胃壁嘅肌肉咧就會收縮放鬆，去攪動翻啲嘢食。從而咧就將佢變翻到細細嚿啦，同一時間亦都會將嗰個嘢食啦同個胃液啦可以撈得埋一齊啦。跟住去到第四啦，就係12指腸啦。12指腸特別想去提嗰種消化液咧，就係膽汁。膽汁嘅主要功能咧就係做乳化 emulsify the large oil droplet into tiny droplet， 跟住由大粒嘅油變成做細細粒嘅油嚟嘅啫。佢又唔會咧已經變做咗呢個 chemical reaction 咧，就變成咗呢個 glycerol 同埋呢個 fatty acid， 變咗甘油同埋脂肪酸，又唔會喎。咁所以啦，都仍然咧係一個物理式嘅消化。嚟咁不厭其煩啦，有一樣嘢都想提嘅，就包 juice 咧，佢係冇包含到呢、這個。EMSA 喺入面嘅，所以佢更加咧就做唔到 chemical digestion 啦。So let's take a look at question 25 and 26. It's talking about the human digestive system. So for the labeling 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So be the good practice, do the labeling first. And the question 25 is asking the physical digestion takes place at which structure? So before we talk about the options, I would like to do a very quick reminder for the physical digestion. It's talking about to break down the food into smaller pieces without changing to a new substance. So that's why for a fish ball, even you chew it, you chew it, you chew it, it just become a smaller fish ball. It doesn't chew the fish ball to become the amino acid or a smaller protein. And for the importance of the physical digestion is to increase the surface area to volume ratio of the food for the digestive enzyme to work on. That means it can facilitate the chemical digestion.So let's take a look at the three structures mentioned in the options A, B, C, D. They are 1, 3, and 4. And I would like to talk about the structure 3 first. That's the large intestine. Actually, no digestion will take place here because the digestion should be complete in the smaller intestine. So that's why there is no physical and chemical digestion in the large intestine. So the main function of the large intestine is to absorb the remaining water and minerals from the feces. So that's why we shall know that number 3 is wrong, is wrong, is wrong. So that's why the final answer must be B. So let's take a look at the stomach and the duodenum. So for the stomach, the muscle of the stomach wall, they can contract and relax to churn the food. That means to mix the food, to break it down into smaller pieces, and also mix well the food with the gastric juice.So imagine that you have the fish ball here, even you chew it, okay, and then when the smaller pieces of the fish ball, they pass through the esophagus, so the chewed food may become a ball again. So that's why when they arrive the stomach, our stomach need to do some mixing, stirring, okay, to make the chewed food become smaller again. And for the duodenum, we need to talk about the bowel juice. The function of the bowel juice is to emulsify the large oil droplet into smaller oil droplet. And in this process, the oil droplet, it just becomes smaller. It will not become the glycerol and the fatty acid. So that's why it's still the physical digestion. And one reminder is that for the bio juice, it doesn't contain enzyme.